There are so many benefits that you can reap from creating great DevOps processes. One benefit of standing up a CI/CD pipeline is that you can incorporate automated QA testing. A best practice when making changes to your code is to have an automated test pipeline in place. This allows for confidence with each change and reduces the likelihood of introducing new bugs. Today, I'm going to play the role of a DevOps engineer, and I'm going to show you how to integrate automatic testing within AWS code pipeline. Since the build step is what is building and deploying our project, this is the first thing we want to look at. If I open up the code build that runs our build spec, and I go into the build details and scroll down to the build spec section, I can see that the build spec is using buildspec.yaml in the source code root directory. What this means is that code build is running based off of a configuration file within our code base. Configuring your CI/CD within your code base is a common best practice because it allows you to have version control not only with your code, but with your DevOps as well. So as a DevOps engineer, I'm going to take a look at this buildspec.yaml now, which is living in the project. This is a typical role I might play to advise and make small changes to the code base itself in order for the code and the CI/CD process to marry up. I can see that we're running yarn install, and then running a command to decrypt some secrets, and then running a deploy command. Switching over to package.json, I see that we already have a test script in place. The developers have set up Jest to run the unit tests. All I have to do is run the proper command in our buildspec.yaml file that runs these Jest tests. To run these tests manually, all I have to do is run yarn test in the command line. And as we can see, all of the tests are passing except one. This means that we currently have a broken test that's been committed to our repository and it was not caught by our DevOps process. Our new process should prevent this from deploying by running these tests automatically and blocking the change if one or more tests fail. Switching back to our build spec file, it's very easy to make these tests run with each code change. All we have to do is simply add the yarn test command before deploying. If the test fails, the entire build will fail. I'm going to add this now and commit this to the develop branch. Now that I've added that change, I'm going to switch back to our code pipeline. And we can see that our code pipeline has kicked off the new change and it's running the build now. Our DevOps process is finished and I can see that the build is now indeed failing. If I open up the build details, I can take a look at the build logs to see the specific cause to the build failure. So when I scroll down, I see that we're running yarn test here, which we added to that buildspec.yaml file. And scrolling down further, I can see the error that we ended up encountering that caused the build to fail. So here's a summary of our build tests here. Now I'm going to go ahead and fix this broken test, which turns out is just a fake test that's intentionally breaking. I'm just going to delete this test and commit a new change to the develop branch. And now I can see that our build is succeeding and the change has deployed. At this point, I already have a test framework in place. However, I'm going to show one more way to use Code Pipeline to go above and beyond with your automated tests and take your process to the next level. I'm going to show how to use Code Pipeline with AWS Lambda to run tests against real processes. This would be the best way to start incorporating automated regression or end-to-end testing directly in your CI/CD pipeline. Switching back to the code project, I've created a Lambda function that acts as a simple regression test for the system. This Lambda is ensuring that our processes are able to connect to the database as expected. This Lambda is actually already deployed, so I'm going to switch back to our code pipeline and show how we can use it within our DevOps process. I'm going to click Edit, and then below our build stage, I'm going to add a new stage, and I'm going to call this stage regression test. And then I'm going to click Add Action Group and name this regression test as well. For the action provider, I'm going to choose AWS Lambda. And then the last thing I need to add is the function name of the Lambda that we're going to use for this stage. And our Lambda is called regression test. I'm going to click Done and click Save. And now I'm going to release a change manually to run our code pipeline again. So the code pipeline process has now finished, and if I scroll down, I can see that the regression test stage actually encountered a failure. If I click the details link here and then click the link to execution details, it will open up the CloudWatch management logs associated with the Lambda itself. And if I look at the latest log stream, I can see that we encountered a DB Connect failure error in our regression test. And opening up this, I can see that we used a bad username in our credentials, and that's causing our regression test Lambda to fail. I'm going to switch over to our project and fix this error really quickly, and then hopefully we should see our regression test passing afterwards. So I went ahead and fixed the bad database username that was causing our regression test to fail. And now, as we can see, our regression test stage is passing. This is just a simple example to show how you can use AWS Lambda in conjunction with Code Pipeline to run more meaningful tests against live systems and unlock the potential to automate regression tests, end-to-end tests, and any other tests you can imagine. Automating your QA testing transforms your software development lifecycle and can really help your organization go above and beyond when implementing DevOps. It frees up countless hours to allow you to drive repeatable and standardized QA testing